discard the cards and see the bottom of the deck for the overall energy at this time. The most important one, what we need to pay attention to. And we do have the Seven of Pentacles. So this is the energy of patience, planting the seeds and, waiting for the harvest. And the Three of Cups. So we do have the energy of happiness and reconciliation. But Seven of Pentacles, right? No, it's not the time. We know Seven of Pentacles is about, it's about timing, but the it's somehow under our power. It's not the divine timing of the Wheel of Fortune. It's something that we actually invested in, and we know it takes time to bear fruit. So, Aquarius, past energy is on your side, the person you are dealing with, and mutual. Let's have current energies on your side, the person you are dealing with, and mutual. And let's have the possible outcome for you, the person you are dealing with, and mutual. Bottom of the deck, Eight of Swords in reverse. Yeah, this is about releasing control. And I kind of feel that we might really want something. It has this energy of impatience and the universe is hitting the brakes, right? With the Seven of Pentacles, it's, you know, in due time, in right time. And Eight of Swords, it's in reverse. So that is something we need to release. We are guided to let go of this energy of mental prison at this time. Being bound to someone, being bound to wanting this reconciliation, being thinking of anything else but this. So Aquarius, what happened in the past? Ten of Cups in reverse and the Devil in reverse. So what happened? We had probably a family, a commitment, a life with this person. Can be a Capricorn, but I kind of feel that it became toxic, right? With the Devil, jealousy, fears, all kinds of conflict that made you unhappy. I mean, Ten of Cups in reverse is like the maximum of unhappiness that we can have with someone. And I kind of feel you kind of had to do something about, right? It's more on your side how difficult it was. And a confirmation, it was for you, it was for them, right? They show up here in the past energies with the Five of Wands and the Nine of Wands. Hurt, conflicted, probably conflicts with you, but conflicts within themselves, a need to feel protected with the Nine of Wands, a need to protect themselves. I don't know if it has this energy of engaging in physical violence, you know, Five of Wands, Nine of Wands is really like physical hurt and emotional hurt and conflict. And so I don't know if that was the case, but that is a lot of aggressiveness, I would say. And this person felt like they had to protect themselves, had to put some distance. Nine Wands is really creating a safe environment for this person. But again, can be your energy, right? You take the side you resonate the most with. This is how it works. It's a general. Mutual energies between the two of you. The Magician in reverse and the King of Pentacles in reverse. That is Virgo and Capricorn. We know Magician in reverse, right? We know it's about manipulation, it's about dishonesty, it's about self-interest, and it's a dynamic, right? It's a dynamic. We get into, you know, we say and do something and somebody else answers, the other person, the other half, the soulmate, the lover, whatever, and we engage into Devil in reverse, Magician in reverse without even realizing. We become toxic ourselves, right? That's how it happens. It's just human. And it became unstable. King of Pentacles, or maybe somebody took off. If it's a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn, put some distance. But I feel that it was a very, very difficult connection. I would say one, and we have mature energies, like the Magician, King of Pentacles, so maybe it lasted for a while, right? And then maybe we stood too long in this connection. And it feels like out of, you know, you did something about, but so did they, right? With the Five of Wands in reverse and the Nine of Wands in reverse. They stopped fighting for this connection and was let go. So Aquarius, where are we right now? Temperance, Sagittarius energy, and the Knight of Swords. This is your energy. So looking for balance, right? Looking for compromise. Trying to see both sides of the story, right? Yours and theirs. And it's a quest for peace. Temperance is really a quest for peace. For some of you, it can be guidance, right? It's a major arcana. We know it's major lessons and pieces of advice. And I kind of feel like, the universe is kind of saying you've been so unhappy and in such a toxic connection that now we need to focus on temperance, on patience, on healing, on balance, on compromise. It's stop fighting. The temperance is a win-win solution. It's a negotiation, right, for some of you. So kind of feel that because you also have your energy in reverse, the Knight of Swords, and the Knight of Swords is a warrior, right, is somebody really getting things done and bluntly going into battle to, you know, to win and solve problems and do something about what's disturbing. And I kind of feel that you are somehow right now stuck a little bit, and the negotiation is the way for some of you, right? Finding a win-win solution. Now, this person of yours, they do have the High Priestess, Pisces, Cancer energy, and the Two of Cups. There is no doubt they still love you. This is a secret love. This is secret emotions. This is doing nothing about still having emotions and doing for you and doing nothing about. It's the energy of observing, of keeping tabs out of love and staying quiet for now. And mutual energies between the two of you. Right now, probably you are emotionally disconnecting. You are walking away, they are walking away, and there is no final decision in this. Or probably, sorry guys, that's my phone. Or probably waiting for a judgment call, waiting for a decision maybe of some sort, you know. So it does have this energy of this is not done yet, right? The judgment is really the last day, the judgment call, and then we start over. It's second chances, and so kind of a statement more of the universe saying, yes, you are disconnecting emotionally, but this is not over. You know, this cycle is not over. And for two reasons, energies are still entangled. One has energies of love. Whoever this person is on this side can be you. And the other one is, in a quest of negotiation, of negotiating and finding the best solution, right? Let's have the possible outcome. Oh, this one is, sorry. I was about to turn it there and I don't know why. It's Four of Pentacles in reverse and the Empress, Libra Taurus energy. But I feel this is the energy of opening up and kindness, Aquarius, and this is the energy of abundance coming your way. Abundance from letting go. Four of Pentacles is a bit of energy of control. And once we let go of things, it comes with this energy of the Empress, right? Things are coming to us. That is an attraction that is put in motion every time we let go of someone and of something and of a situation, and we don't control the outcome. Then, all the laws of the universe are, free to flow and bring balance to a situation, which is actually their role. Now, this person of yours, Knight of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, and the Seven of Cups, we have them a little bit confused, right? Contemplating options, moving slowly, slowly, right? Still wanting to be friends, not knowing are we still friends or not. And mutual energies between the two of you, Four of Cups and the King of Cups, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy, and the not paying attention. So for the month of March, Aquarius, it is patience for reconciliation. If that is one message in the overall energy is, pull yourself out of a mental prison and take the time for this, whatever reconciliation and happiness is coming. Take your time and be patient about, right? Because right now one is confused, the other one is controlling an outcome. I love the Eight of Cups at the core of the reading. I believe that after so many conflicts and fights and internal struggle and toxic energies, I do feel that we need to rest emotionally. That's my Eight of Cups, right? Yeah, it's a disconnection. I know it's a call for a mission, but I feel it's more about emotional rest and gaining some perspective to this, right? Because we are still in so many energies. Now, on their side, there is no doubt they still have emotions and love, but they are also hurt and confused. Yeah, let's ask for some guidance. Let's see what we need to know. Let's see what we have. Oh, resolving conflict. So not surprised. I mean, I cannot create that, right? Resolving conflict. And you do have temperance right now. So I feel that, I don't know if you are in that dynamic of, you know, wanting to make them pay or God knows what. I feel you are guided to solve a problem, put the energies back into the flow. We do have choose love. You always have choice. Make yours with love. And we have I love you. These are powerful words. So we say it to important people. We say it, you know, when we mean it. That's very important. And we have dating. Aquarius, I do feel that you are guided towards other people at this point to choose love. Date. Maybe you are guided to choose someone who said I love you, who says I love you, who won't say I love you soon. And we do have reparenting yourself. So this is about unlearning patterns and learning new ones. Learning new ways of doing life, love, connections, relationships, you name it. Okay. So let's look into the energies we are guided to put back into the flow or to release. And we have surrendered to setting limits. It is healthy to set boundaries in relationships. Practice expressing your needs. And remember that no is a complete sentence. We do have denial. I acknowledge my fear, but I replace it with the insight of awareness. So if you are in denial about something, and I kind of feel the Eight of Swords might be the denial, the mental prison, the obstacles, feeling that you cannot move on from an energy that is keeping you hostage and limited and confined. I feel that, and you do have dating. You are really guided towards someone else to open yourself up to new possibilities, opportunities. And we do have service. I feel good when I can help others. And we have death. I'm not surprised again. We need to let go of someone for now. Because we started with the Seven of Pentacles, right? It's for now. It's still the harvest time. So I'm learning that endings are merely beginnings, and bottom of the deck, surrender to prayer. Give yourself over completely to prayer. When you pray from your heart, you will be heard throughout the universe, and answers and support will arrive. So I feel do not give up, do not give up, open up. If that is one piece of guidance here, is like give yourself another chance with somebody else after you learn new ways of doing relationships, right? Reparenting yourself. Or maybe be the parent you never had to yourself at this moment, because it looks like a tough time with this person. And again, it's not that they don't love you, it's just that they are confused and hurt. So Aquarius, this is all that I have for you guys. You know I love you. I wish you nothing but the best. I want you to stay strong and safe, and come see me next time. Love you. Take care.